is Ethan Yoder. I'm with DB Services, and today I'll be showing you FM Draw. So FM Draw is a tool that allows you to mark up images directly inside of your FileMaker database with no need for a third-party application. So the first step in installing FM Draw is downloading it from our website. So inside of the article, you should see a little download link at the bottom. Just download it, and you should get a little zip file like this. So you want to open up that zip file and then move this folder into the add-on modules folder. So you can actually find this located at this file path below. You would change eyoder to be your username. And then on Windows, it's a pretty similar process where you just move that folder into this file path right here. Again, where administrator would be your username. So once you have the add-on module saved, you actually want to make sure FileMaker is closed. I'm just going to quit FileMaker right now. And then you want to open up the file that you want to put FMDraw into. So in this case, I just have this little sample file called images. Okay, so you can see that I have a couple images here on the left-hand side. But first, you actually need to add the add-on into your file. So you just want to find this add-on panel on the left-hand side and click the plus button. And you should see this FM Draw add-on in the JavaScript section. So choose this and just drag it onto your layout, like so. And then you can also make this window as big or as small as you would like to. You know, I can resize it to this big. I could make it, you know, this small, right? Now, I wouldn't recommend making it too small because it might cut off some of those colors or some of the tools on the top panel. But overall, you can make it about as big or as small as you would like. Now, right now what we're showing is a blank canvas, so I can actually draw on this with my pencil tool. I can actually change the color of my pencil if I would like. So we have an array of colors over here on the side. Instead of drawing, I can actually make circles or ovals. I can also make squares if I would like to, or arrows. I can do these in all sorts of colors, right? So those are the first four tools. This fifth tool actually allows you to drag or rotate or resize any of the elements that you've created, right? So I can shrink this, right? I can rotate it. Or if you just want to remove an element entirely, you can just drag it off of the canvas and it will be gone, right? Great. So once I have this image marked up as I want, I can actually save it. So this will allow me to save it at a particular file path. So I'll just save that to my desktop, and you'll see the image can be found right here. So that's great. So let's say I'm done with that. I want to clear it out. I can just click this refresh button right here, and it will reset my canvas. So there's actually a few more options that you can use. So if I click this panel right here, which, by the way, this will only show up for full access users. So if you are not a full access user, this settings button will not show up for you. So this is the settings panel. So we have a couple of different options on the setting panel. So for example, I can choose an image container that I would like the canvas to pull from. So in this case, it's showing me all of the container fields inside of the particular table that I put this canvas onto, right? So I will just show you that really quickly. So I am on the image layout, and you can see in my image table, I have three containers, one called image, one called view, and one called picture. So now when I go back to my settings, you can see that it shows all three of those container fields inside of this dropdown. So I can actually choose any one of these. So in this case, I'll choose image, right? So that'll be the field that I pull from. And now you can see I can draw on this image, right? I can make little squares, all that good stuff, right? And I can actually save it from FileMaker as well. And the great thing about this is that whenever you save it, it will actually save it as the exact same size as your image. So it won't scale down or scale up your image. It will save as the exact same size. Great. So that's one option. Now, if I actually remove that image, it just gives me a blank canvas, right? So if you have an image field, or if you have an image container chosen and it's empty, it will just show you a blank canvas. So let me just put that back in. And there we go. You also have a couple different options when it comes to where to save it. So you can actually save this directly into a container field as well. So in this case, I'm going to choose view. So I'm going to draw on my picture. When I click save, you'll see it shows up in my view. So I'm going to export this. Let's replace the previous image. And you can see it's my newly marked up image. Great. So you can also make it save over itself. So I can just say, okay, great. Let's just save it back into that same container. So when I save, you can see that it overwrites the previous image, and I can continue to draw on it. So the other great part about this is that you can actually have multiple canvases at the same time. So if I resize this canvas right here, all I have to do is just drag another canvas onto this layout. And you can see that I now have two canvases. And so these canvases actually will have separate settings. So in this case, these settings correspond to this particular canvas. But if I look at this one, it's not pulling from any images, right? Even if I refresh it, nothing's there. So these actually have their separate settings, right? So I can pull from picture in this one and save it into view. Now I can write on this one and click save. So you can see that my image has been saved into the view field. So again, these two canvases have completely separate settings. So that'll wrap up my presentation today of FM Draw. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to the DB Services team at dbservices.com. Thank you.